say 1917, over 100 years ago. And despite that, the things that we've done have been just incredible. And I couldn't have done it without you. So just a goodbye. We love you. We will be back in some form. And again, I want to thank our Vice President, Mike Pence, and Karen. I want to thank Congress, because we really worked well with Congress, at least certain elements of Congress. But we really did. We've gotten so much done that nobody thought would be possible. But I do want to thank Congress. And I want to thank all of the great people of Washington, D.C., all of the people that we worked with to put this miracle together. So have a good life. We will see you soon. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Have a good life. We'll see you soon. A fitting end to the Trump presidency, a speech full of puffery and lies. Although, of course, with this president, it always could have been worse. There weren't the worst of his typical lies about the election. He did acknowledge that there is an incoming administration, but we don't have to grade on a curve. It was an embarrassment that he did not even mention the name of his successor, Joe Biden, and the fact that he is making it all about himself and not about the country at all.
Not about at his inauguration. That is what he leaves behind in a Washington which is in lockdown.
Incredible that he circled the Capitol in Marine One.
To survey,
and what
the
he saw
he
was a Capitol surrounded by fence and razor wire and troops. That is his legacy. That is what he has left. Now comes the work of taking that fencing down and rebuilding our democracy.
Wolf?
You know, it's really a contrast that we're seeing now. The incoming president, President-elect Biden, attending church services, the soon-to-be former president of the United States at what seemed to be a little bit of a campaign rally at Joint Base Andrews. Totally inappropriate, I must say, the music that was playing there. But that was a campaign rally as opposed to a formal departure ceremony, and the fact that he avoided even congratulating, saying anything about the new president of the United States was pretty repulsive as we're watching this unfold. We're only about 3 hours away from the swearing-in ceremony of the new president and new vice president of the United States. You're looking at live pictures from Capitol Hill right now. Caitlin Collins, you're getting some new information. What are you